Friends, we have in the previous two videos we did some problems on welding. I think you have understood that. Now I am going to the sheet metal shop. In this video I am going to sheet metal shop. Now in sheet metal we are using sheet. Normally we use GI sheet of thickness 1 mm, or it will be not, it will be always less than 3 mm sheet. Now this sheet is sold not by weight, by area. Area, its rate will be, rate of sheet will be so many rupees per square meter, that is 1 meter by 1 meter. 1 meter this way, 1 meter this way, this makes an area of 1 square meter. So the rate will be given as so many rupees per square meter and not per kg. If it is in welding shop, it will be rupees per kg. Here generally it will be rupees per square meter. So what we have to do here is the material cost is to be found out. The rate will be given. Now the product will be given to us. Now we have to find out what is the area of the sheet that is required and to make that particular product. Then rate into area required will give you the cost of the product. Here yes, little knowledge of joints that come in sheet metal. You know, joints is necessary. Now you get joints like this. See, let us say this is the sheet from which we are making it. Here let us say we are making a cylindrical this thing, like a can, you know, Coca-Cola Coca can or something like that, some drink cans. Now here you have seen that a sheet will be taken, a thin sheet will be taken, it will be folded. You don't do welding here. What we do is we use a groove joint like this. Like this you do a groove joint. This is called a double groove joint. If it is double groove joint, then the allowance is to be given in finding area. The allowance is usually for a groove joint, double groove joint, 10T, that is 10 times the thickness of the sheet. 10 times the thickness of the sheet. If it is single groove joint, it will be 5T. If it is double groove joint, single groove joint, it, the allowance given is this thing. And if it is a seam joint, seam joint, it will be 8T. So this you must remember to calculate. When you are calculating this area, you have to draw the development of this. When you open this, what will be the this thing, then what will be the area required, you will have to find out and do it. Now we will take up, these are the types of joints that come. Then there are different operations which come in that. You will have to know those operations in theory. Now in problem you will get problems like this. I am taking problem again by the question bank, from the question bank. The question number 9, estimate the cost of metal sheet for preparing a funnel as shown in figure. Assume the wastage of metal as 10%. Wastage means here it is covering these joints as 10%, and cost of sheet, sheet cost, that is rate, rate of the sheet is rupees 50 per square meter. Square meter. He has given a this thing, a sketch. This is the sketch of the funnel. This is 10 centimeter dia. 10 centimeter dia. Here it is 4 centimeter dia, I think. this is 4 centimeter dia, that is 10 centimeter dia. Then again here it is to be joined there, and here it is 2 centimeter dia. This length is 6 centimeters, and this is 8 centimeter. From this sketch we have to find out what is the sheet required, and after getting the sheet we have to find its cost. That is what is to be done, and for doing this we have to draw the development. There are two parts here. This is the upper part and the lower part. The development means opening it like this. It is like this, it is to be opened. If this a conical, this thing is opened, this is what you will get. This is the sheet that you get. This is the sheet you will get. Then its area, the area of this will be equal to, L means slant height. This is what is given here is vertical height, H. Slant height means this way. Slant height divided by 2 into sum of the circumferences. Sum of the circumferences here, that is pi d1 plus pi d2. Or you can take out that pi outside. It will be pi l by 2 into d1 plus d2. That is the sum of the circumferences, sum of the circumferences at the top and at the bottom. This will give you the area. You have to find the area, and then into rate will give you the cost. This is the problem. Now, we will take the first part, upper part. I will call this as 1, this as 2. First, we have to find out this slant height, this length, that is called as the slant height. Slant height of part 1, that is, I will call it as L1, will be equal to this. I know this is H. This will be d1 minus d2 divided by 2, because half will be this side and half will be that side, d1 minus d2 by 2. So this length will be, L will be equal to square root of h square plus, because this is hypotenuse here, d1 minus d2 by 2 the whole square. This is the formula for finding that slant height, L1. So L1 will be equal to h square, that is 8 square plus d1 minus d2, that is 10 minus 4 divided by 2 the whole square. 10 minus 4 is 6, 6 divided by 2 is 3. This will be 8 square plus 3 square under root, that is 64 plus 9, I think it is 73 under root. 73 under root will be, I'll do it once, 8 square plus 3 square is equal to 73. Root of answer equals 8.54 centimeters, or 8.55 centimeter will take. This is this thing. So A1 will be equal to area of sheet required there will be equal to A1 will be equal to pi L1 by 2 into D1 plus D2, that is D1 plus D2. Now pi into L1, that is 8.55 divided by 2 into D1 plus D2, that is 10 centimeter plus 8 centimeter, plus 4 centimeters, 14 plus 4. Yes, 4. So it will be 0.55 into pi into 14 divided by 2 will give me 188, roughly 188 square centimeters, because I have put this in centimeter, this in centimeter, this in centimeter. If you add 10 centimeter and 4 centimeter, the total is 14 centimeter. 14 centimeter into 8.55, it becomes square centimeter. Now we have to convert that into meter square, because the rate is given in meter square. So 188 divided by 100, again divided by 100, that will be 0.0188 square meters. What I have done is I have divided this by 100 into 100. That is because centimeter square means centimeter into centimeter, so there are 2 centimeters there. To convert one of them, I have to divide it by 100 into meters. I have to divide it by 100. So 100 into 100 it will be. So A1 is 0.0188 square meters. Similarly, you have to find out L2 now. L2, this is H1. L2. L2, that is here in this part, will be equal to root of 6 square plus 4 minus 2 divided by 2 the whole square, that is 36. This will be 1 square. 4 minus 2 is 2, 2 by 2 is 1, 1 square will be 1 only. So root of 37, the root of 37 is 6.08 centimeter. So A2 will be equal to pi L2 divided by 2 into D2 plus D3 here. So pi into 6.08 divided by 2 into 4 plus 2, 4 plus 2, 6, 6 into 6.08 plus, 6.08 into pi divided by 2, that gives me 57.3 square centimeter, or it is divided by 100, again divided by 100, that will give me 0.00573 meter square. this is the one. Next, total area of sheet required. Total area of sheet required will be total area of sheet required will be A1 plus A2 plus wastage. That is 0.0188 square meters plus 0.00573 square meters plus wastage is 10% of the total area, that is 0.0188 plus 0.00573. This will give me the total area. 10% is wastage, he says. So that is to be taken into consideration. So here, what I will do is 0.0188 plus 0.00 left 10. 0.00573 equals 0.024 into, if I multiply by 1.1, I will get the 0.027 square meters. So cost of sheet will be equal to area into rate, that is area is 0.0727 into rate is 50 rupees per square meter. So 0.027 plus into 50, that works out to 1.35 rupees. Is the cost of sheet required to make one funnel of that size, right? We'll take one more problem from the question bank on sheet metal and we'll solve it. This is slightly different from what we did earlier. This is the 11th problem, the last one in the question bank. A cylindrical drum of size 2.75 meter high and 1.5 meter mean dia is to be fabricated from sheet of 5 mm thickness by grooved seam joint, and both the ends are to be closed by sheet with single seam joint. Determine the material cost if the sheet is available at rupees 2000 per square meter. If the sheet is available at rupees 2000 per square meter, here the product to be manufactured is a steel drum like this. Steel drum from a sheet you are going to make it. So here this height is 2.75 meter and the dia is required, dia is mean dia is how much? 1.5 meter dia. From this dimension you have to make it. Now imagine that it is like this. So you have taken a sheet, folded it like this, and here you have made a joint, and then here also you have to close it, here also you have to close it. Now the middle portion, lateral portion, if you draw the development, it will be a rectangle. If you draw the it will be a rectangle. This is pi into d, circumference of this circle. This, if you open, this is the circumference. If you open it, this will be pi d, and this is the height. This is the height. Right. Here, there is a joint. What type of joint? Closed by a sheet with single seam, by a grooved seam joint. I think here you have to give an allowance of, this is for joint, you have to give an allowance of 10 times t. I think here you have to give an allowance of, this is seam joint, think 8t and 8t here. So that the lid, both ends could be placed and pressed. So this is 8t here, that is 8t, total 16t. And then you require two circular plates, that is lids, are to be provided, and their area is also to be found out. So now area of sheet required to make one, this thing will be equal to, area of sheet will be equal to pi d square by 4, that is these lids, two lids, so into 2, plus pi d, this one, plus 10 plus 10t into h plus 16t. So this will be, I think you are following me. This is the area of two lids, this circular plate, this circular plate. This is a rectangle. Its length is pi d plus 10t. The width is h plus 16t. So this will be pi into d is 1.5 square divided by 4 into 2 plus pi into 1.5 plus 10 into thickness of the sheet is given as 5 mm. 5 mm means 5 by 1000. To convert it into meters, that means it is 5 by 100, 0.005 meters, plus, sorry, not plus, into h is 2.5 meters, plus 16 into 5 divided by 1000. So first add these two. Two point five plus eighty divided by thousand. That will be 2.58. This is pi into 1.5 plus 0.005, that will be 4.72. 2.58 into 4.72 will give me 12.17 plus pi into 1.5 square divided by 4 into 2 will give me 15.71, or I'll take it as 15.7 square meters. Now the rate is given as 2000. So cost will be area into rate, that is 15.7 square meters into 2000 into 15.7 into 2000 will give me 31,400 rupees. That is the cost of the sheet which is required. So this is how the problem is to be done. Okay, I think you have understood it. You please like, comment, share and subscribe, and you can also ask any doubts. You can call me and ask. Thank you.